Hey, what is going on, guys? So as you can see, the set is finally rebuilt, and along with it, my new studio slash office is coming together quite nicely. Over the past couple of days, I've been able to check off many different items in my little studio rebuilding project in my to-do list. And speaking of to-do lists, well, we gotta talk about those, because I get a lot of questions about which app or tool out there is the best one for managing your tasks. So in today's video, I wanna try to answer that question. And to do so, I'm gonna be sharing my top three to-do list applications that I think are gonna be the best options for most people. And I'm also gonna throw in one kind of oddball recommendation that doesn't really fit in with the other three, but might be useful for certain viewers. So let's get into it. All right, so the number one app on my list, which you've probably seen if you've ever looked at the resources page on my website or asked me about it on Twitter, is Todoist. Now, back when I was in college, I used to use a task management app called Wunderlist, and I absolutely loved it. But a few years ago, Microsoft actually bought it, and they made the announcement that it was eventually going to be going away. And as a result, I moved over to Todoist. And just to kind of spoil this video a little bit for you, I think that Todoist is probably the best to-do app out there in terms of features and capabilities. And the number one feature that it offers, something that I find invaluable in my workflow, is natural language processing, which means that you can add tasks along with all the details needed for those tasks, such as tags and due dates and assignees and things like that, just by typing what you want in the main taskbar or by saying it. I'm also a big fan of the quick add feature. When I'm using the app on my desktop or in the browser, I can just hit the letter Q, or I can just hit the plus button on my iPhone, and I can easily enter a task in seconds. And that reduces a lot of friction in my system. Additionally, I'm a big fan of its integration with voice assistants. It's got Siri integration, and it's also got Amazon Echo integration. And don't worry, I'm not going to say the A word in this video, but if I want to, I can easily tell my Echo to add a task, and it gets automatically added to my inbox. And I love that since I have several of them in my house. That being said, not everything is perfect with Todoist. I do think that the way it handles subtasks is a little dated, and I'm not a big fan of how you just indent things in your main task list instead of having a real subtasks view. And additionally, the Windows app doesn't work quite like the desktop app, the Mac app, or even the mobile apps. It's got kind of a different UI, and it doesn't work quite as well. Additionally, Todoist is not the cheapest app in the personal productivity space, especially since they just raised their prices to $4 a month. So that might be a bit of a turnoff. Though it is worth mentioning that there is a student discount, though they did make the baffling decision to require people to sign up for a business account before asking for it. But even still, it reduces the price down to about $1.50 per month. So if you are a college student, that is an option for you. However, if you are a price conscious person, or you're just somebody who doesn't want to pay a monthly subscription fee for your to-do list app, then there's something else that you're going to want to look at, and that is Microsoft To-Do. So let me level with you here. If you're somebody who just does not want to pay for your to-do list application and you have simple needs, then I think Microsoft To-Do is the absolute best option on the market right now. A couple of years ago, I would not have made this recommendation, as when it came out as the replacement for Wunderlist, there were a lot of missing features. But over the past couple of years, Microsoft's team has added a lot of needed features to the app. And honestly, it's pretty darn good, especially for having absolutely no premium tier whatsoever. You've got the ability to make multiple projects. You can color code those projects. Subtasks actually work like they're supposed to, and unlike Todoist's free plan, you can add comments and file attachments to your tasks in Microsoft To-Do without paying anything. This is actually the main reason why I recommend Microsoft To-Do over Todoist's free plan if you just don't want to pay. I do think Todoist is more powerful overall, but I think a lot of people are going to want the ability to add descriptions and comments to their tasks. Like, say if you want to set up a PO box, you need to put the address of the post office box in the task. You have to pay for that in Todoist. Now, granted, Microsoft To-Do does not have natural language features, so you do have to set your due dates and stuff like that manually. But if you want something simple, I think it really works. And it also has some pretty cool features that you're not going to find in other apps, such as the My Day feature, which doesn't pull tasks based on due dates, but instead lets you manually add tasks from your lists. Now, of course, there are some things with Microsoft To-Do that I don't like. For instance, there isn't a dedicated Mac app right now, so just like Todoist on the Windows side, I've got to use Microsoft To-Do in the browser. Additionally, like I said earlier, it is not quite as powerful as other apps like Todoist. You don't have the natural language features, you don't have tags and filters and smart lists and things like that. But again, if you don't want to pay and you want something simple, I think it is a very compelling option. That brings us to my third recommendation on this list, which is an app called Ticktick. And if you've ever used Ticktick before, you probably know that it is eerily similar to Todoist. Just like Todoist, it's got those natural language features which allow you to get tasks into your system very quickly and have it just parse all the information you want instead of having to set it yourself. It's got tags you can add to your tasks, and it's got something called smart lists, which function basically the exact same way that filters do in Todoist. But there are some features in Ticktick that you're not going to find in Todoist. For example, there is a built-in calendar view, so if you want to look at your tasks on a bi-week or bi-month basis, you can actually do that. There are start times you can add to your tasks, which I don't personally use, but some people find to be very useful. There's a built-in Pomodoro timer, which can actually be tied to your tasks. So if you want to do Pomodoros throughout the day and actually bind them to the tasks you have in your system, you can do that. And subtasks actually work the way that they should. You click into a task and you can see your subtasks along with all the related information like file attachments and comments. Beyond that, there are even more features in Ticktick, such as desktop widgets, which I kind of irrationally love. I'm not sure why I like them so much, but it's kind of cool to have like a semi-transparent box on my desktop with all my tasks. And on the mobile side, there's a feature called Plan My Day, which helps you intelligently plan out what you want to get done on a given day. Given all these features and the fact that Ticktick is cheaper than Todoist at $28 a year versus their $36 a year, it might seem like Ticktick is the better option. And for some people, it might be, but there are a few caveats. For one, Ticktick does have those natural language features, but they're not as strong as the ones found in Todoist. For example, I can't use TOM for tomorrow. I actually have to type out the entire thing. And when I'm using a really complex request, like having a task with a specific first due date along with a recurring option, it can't really parse it. Todoist handles it like a champ, but I have to go in and manually set that kind of thing up in Ticktick. Additionally, there is no two-way Google Calendar sync in Ticktick, so while you do have that built-in calendar view, if you want to actually look at it on your Google Calendar, you can't quite do that as well as you can on Todoist. And perhaps most importantly of all, their free plan is very limited. You can only have 9 lists. That brings us to my oddball recommendation, which really isn't that odd. It just kind of exists outside of the realm of the simple to-do list style apps that most of you guys are probably familiar with. So my final recommendation for this video is something called ClickUp, which is an app that you would probably categorize as project management software instead of a simple to-do list app. Project management apps, which don't really include the tools we've already talked about, but do include tools like Asana and Jira and ClickUp, are a little better suited for managing really complex projects with lots of moving parts, different task statuses, and for managing teams. Now, for a long time, I was a big Asana user, mainly because my friend Matt got me on it, and it was pretty useful, but after testing ClickUp, I think it is probably the most useful and most full-featured project management app that I've ever tried, and it might also work for personal productivity. ClickUp gives you a ton of different ways to look at your tasks. You've got a normal list view, you've got a board view, which is kind of Trello or Kanban style, you've got a calendar view, or you can go full project manager and even look at Gantt charts. When it comes to creating tasks, you basically have all the options. There's a full-fledged hybrid markdown editor for descriptions that rivals Notions or Slides. There's the ability to add subtasks and checklists, and you can generate these checklists from templates. In fact, you can generate entire tasks from templates. And of course, you get your due dates, recurring due dates with more options than you can shake a stick at. There's task watchers, and you can even assign multiple people to one task. And then there are the tools. There's the ability to minimize tasks to a task tray, which kind of gives you the ability to make a little daily list of tasks that you're gonna work on. There's a notepad feature built into the app for making just scratch notes. And possibly my favorite additional tool is their Chrome extension, because it lets you take a screenshot of a web page and append it to an existing task or make a new task out of it. And when Martin and I were working on fixing some bugs on the College Info Geek website, this was actually really, really useful. So if you are the kind of person who wants incredibly fine-grained control over every aspect of your life, or you want to take heavy advantage of templating and team features, then ClickUp might be something to look at. That being said, after testing ClickUp extensively for a couple of weeks with my team, I ended up making the decision to move us all back to Todoist. And the main reason for doing that is that ClickUp just gives us too many options, and we found that there was a lot of friction involved in adding new tasks to the system and figuring out where they should go. Whereas in Todoist, we can use those natural language features to get something into the system really quickly. However, during that testing period, I was really impressed with all the different features they're offering, and I do think that it offers a lot more flexibility and capabilities than similar apps like Asana. So for a certain kind of person, it's gonna be a pretty compelling option. So that brings us to the final question, which is, which of these apps is the best one? And it's kind of hard to answer that question objectively since everyone has different needs, so I'm gonna give you a couple of different recommendations. First and foremost, if you don't want to pay for your task management software, then Microsoft To-Do is really compelling. If you really want the natural language features, then maybe Todoist Free Plan is for you, Otherwise, if you want something simple, you want something that works and has some pretty cool features all of its own, then Microsoft To Do is pretty cool. If you are willing to pay a few bucks a month for a subscription though, for my money at least, Todoist is the best general task management app out there for most people. Now, Ticktick is really compelling. It's quite similar and it does have a few additional features like that Pomodoro timer, but at least for me, the superior natural language processing, which allows me to get tasks into my system more accurately and more quickly, gives Todoist the edge. Now, regardless of which task management app you end up going with, one of the tasks that you should put on it and do as soon as you possibly can is getting yourself a domain name. It's no secret that more and more companies are relying on the internet to find their job candidates. So if you want to position yourself as the best possible person for that job you're looking for, then you should be looking to establish a strong personal brand online. And a really important part of that process is building yourself a website where you can communicate your skills, show off your portfolio, and make it really easy for people to contact you. And of course, the first step to doing that is securing a domain name for yourself, something that you can link to from your online profiles and even put on your resume and business cards. And the best place on the internet to get that domain name is Hover. Unlike some other places, Hover makes the process of getting a domain name super easy. In fact, I just bought one this morning and the process took less than 30 seconds. There are no annoying upsells, nothing to get in your way, just a frictionless and streamlined checkout process. Plus, with over 400 different domain extensions to choose from, like the classic .coms and .me's, to some more interesting ones like .lol and .ninja, you've got a lot of choices. And once you've got that domain name, you can easily set up a professional email address for it or use their Connect feature to automatically hook it up to different website builders like Squarespace and Shopify. So head over to hover.com/ThomasFrank to get your domain name before somebody else does. And if you use that link, which you'll find in the description down below, you're also gonna get 10% off your first purchase. Big thanks to Hover for sponsoring this video and being a big supporter of my channel. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button. You can also subscribe right there to get new videos every single week when they come out, or click right there to get a copy of my book on how to earn better grades for free. If for some reason you don't wanna click on either of those boxes, you can go follow me on Instagram at TomFrank, or click right over here to see one more video on this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.